Hey guys, good morning. Please let me know if you can see me and all. I'll just meanwhile upload the PDFs. Hello Alok. What about others? Nobody is here. Guys, come on. It's early morning. You should be enthusiastic, no? You can hear me, right? Everybody, you can see me, hear me, no? Kuch bolo, yaar. Come on, guys. Yes, very good. Chalo, theek hai. Good morning, Neha. Hello, Rohit. Chalo, so as you know, this is a special class of An Academy, which is going to aid you in your preparation for UPSC examinations. And regularly every day between 9:30 to 12, you can enroll for these An Academy special classes. And you just have to pay 1 rupee to be a part of this, where you know, you will get a comprehensive coverage of a single topic. For example, today I'm going to do cyber security with you guys. Theek hai? So every day you can check out the plus tab. There you can enroll for these courses. And I'm also sorry, I think the message did not go for you on time at the class. I took it to the Rashtrapati Bhavan. So basically my dad is in the Swachh Bharat mission. So there was a lunch hosted by the Prime Minister. And my father was supposed to go there, but then he went on a Mumbai trip. So he said, you please go on behalf of me since you already have the pass. And he just told me in the morning, so I had no other option. I'm really sorry, it caused a lot of inconvenience to you all. Take care. Even I also did not want to miss an opportunity like that to go to for a lunch with the minister and see him live. So I'm sorry for the inconvenience, okay? Take care. And related aspects. Okay, chalo. So first of all, let us start with the very basic question. What do you mean by cyber security? Yes, any simple definition anybody can give you? Whatever, you know, cyber security. What comes to your mind? Protecting your computer, laptop, yeah? Guys, come on. Be interactive, yaar. Batao. What do you think? I tell you, cyber security. What do you think? This is a very crucial topic. Because if you see, for the past 3 years, they have been continuously asking one question or the other. And specifically, I think in the last year, they asked two questions. Okay, security of our internet system. Okay, fine. Data theft. Okay, Anand Mitra is saying, Alok is saying security of our internet system. Very good. See, basically, the thing is protection of PC, mobile from cyber attack. Yes, everything. Whatever, you are going to the digital world or the electronic world. Okay, for example, you have your personal computer. There is so many data to it, like your laptops are there, your smartphones are there, or the network that you are using. Okay, so there is a chance that, you know, so you leave your laptop somewhere and I open it and I access some important files on your laptop or your personal computer, or I steal your phone and access your data, or using the internet I access your data, your personal data. Okay, am I authorized to use your data? Of course not. I'm an unknown person to you. So this is basically an unauthorized and malafide access. Malafide means I'm doing it with a bad intention. Your data. I want to put some, private things in the public domain. With malafide intentions, I'm accessing your network or your personal devices, personal electronic devices. Okay. For stealing information or disrupting it. I want to delete everything. For example, let us say you have been involved in a project for 2 years. Okay, and you have accumulated lots of data, etc. I'm going to steal it, I'm going to delete it for you. So that's a loss to you, right? So cyber security is basically when you're trying to protect your electronic devices, okay, via your internet system, your smartphone, your laptops, etc., from malafide and unauthorized access. This is cyber security, okay? Okay, clear, no? Not very complicated, right? You're just protecting your electronic devices, that's all. Okay, we will talk about how you can do that in the later stage. Why people do cyber attack? Lots of reasons. For example, let us say I want to, you know, I'm Pakistan and I want to know where, Indian troops are positioned. So I will do a cyber attack. Okay, I'll carry out a cyber attack, or I want to, you know, eavesdrop. I want to hear the communication that is going on between the Prime Minister and Home Minister every day. So for that, I can do a cyber attack. Okay, that will compromise the security of the nation. Or let us say I'm a competitor, you are Jio and I am Airtel. I'm trying to steal important data from you. These are the reasons. Okay? Or I want to blackmail you for something. All those things. Or I want to bring the image down, your image down. For example, let's say you are a politician, you are contesting against, a big person. So what I do is I bring something about your private life into the public domain. So everybody will hate you. They will not vote for you. And you will lose credibility. All these reasons are there. Okay? Chalo, what are the challenges in the cybersecurity? Why is it a constant and an ever-evolving challenge? First of all, large user base. Increasing. Every day new people are signing up for Facebook, new people are signing up for Twitter, new people are signing up on Instagram. So the base is already very large. Billions of people are using, one way or the other, they are connected to the internet. Billions of people are using the network. Okay, and it is increasing every single day. Okay, and as you know, India is one of the largest base for that. You know, Facebook and all, the maximum number of people are from India, right? If I'm not mistaken. Indians hi to hai maximum on Facebook. The population wise, or the population percentage wise, yes, they are increasing every day. There are no geographical barriers. There are no geographical barriers. For example, if I want to cross into Pakistan, there is a physical barrier against you. I have to go through the border security and all. Okay. But what about me sending a friend request to somebody in Japan? I can do it, no? There is no geographical barrier for me. Okay, this is a big challenge. So somebody sitting at Russia, somebody sitting at USA, somebody sitting at Brazil can access my data. Okay. For example, I'm not physically near you. You might be in Northeast, or you might be in Kashmir, or you might be at Kanyakumari or Gujarat, or maybe Andaman Nicobar Islands. I don't know, but still you're able to see me, no? So there are no geographical boundaries over here. Okay. Then detection and attribution of attacker is difficult. Somebody carried out an attack from Pakistan. How will you find where in Pakistan this person is located? How will you attribute this particular crime to him? Even if you can attribute this particular crime to him, can you really arrest him for this? Is it possible for you to do that? Of course not. This is another challenge in cybersecurity domain. National laws become extraneous. National laws become useless. How will you prosecute a person? Let us say somebody sitting in Pakistan carried out a cyber attack on you. So, do you think your Indian laws can apply over there and you can punish that person? Of course not. This is another challenge. Okay. Technology in the cyberspace is constantly evolving. Okay. So, you think, fine, I have the best security system. But tomorrow, people have found a hack for that also. Then for that, you have to come up with a new security system. Then people have found a hack for the new security system. Again, people evolve the new security system. And this keeps on happening, no? So, that is the reason you need to constantly update, for example, your antivirus, etc. Why is it that they require constant updates? Why? Because it is constantly evolving. If you have come up with a mechanism to prevent an attack, those people out there are finding new ways to attack you. Then these people who want to protect you, they are finding new ways to protect you. So this game continues on because the technology in the cyberspace is constantly evolving. Okay? So therefore, because of this, foolproof cybersecurity architecture is impossible. It is impossible for you to come up with an architecture and say, this is foolproof. Nobody will be able to break through. So, okay. So this is the reason, be it CIA, be it FBI, or be it CBI, etc. They need to constantly update their cybersecurity modules. Okay. Unlike the usual security problem like terrorism, extremism, and insurgency, etc. Cybersecurity is very different. You cannot compare them with terrorism, extremism, and insurgency, right? These are traditional threats to your security. But this is completely different. The domain is completely different. Are you getting this? Challenges? No. Okay. Chalo, you have any doubt, you can just stop me and ask me. Okay. So let us talk about India's cybersecurity preparedness. For example, we have institutions like CERTIN and NIC. Then we have the Information Technology Act of 2000. Then we came up with the National Cybersecurity Policy of 2013. Then we have something called as National Critical Information Infrastructure Protection Center. Okay. Then there is a constant liaison between the private sector regarding cybersecurity incidents. Okay. So these are some of the laws, etc., that we have made for cybersecurity preparedness. So you can just read a little bit about them, or in the future, I will be uploading more lessons. Okay. On the free platform, you can get to know them. If I start discussing this, then I might not be able to finish the what I would like to teach you. Okay. So this you can look up later, or you can look it up on the Unacademy free platform. There I will make a, you know, lesson covering all this. Okay, so let us talk about threats to India's cyber security. What are threats that India is facing? Okay, first of all is digital India, na? We want to digitize everything. We are saying, no, chalo ye paper band karo, let us make everything digital. Payment, we have UPI and all these things, we are trying to go digital. For example, there is this digi locker where you can store your certificates, etc. Digital India. So if you cannot provide cyber security to that, everything will go away, no? The national e-governance plan, that is of course your digital India. Then Aadhaar card, everyone, all of you have given, no? Your iris you have given, your thumbprint you have given, you have linked it to your PAN, everything you have done. Okay, and for the, with the government, everything is there. Right to privacy, chodo. That is gone long ago. So you have given everything. So if the government is not able to protect it, what will happen? Your identity will be compromised, no? Don't you think so? Your identity, everything about you will be compromised. Security threat for us, government is storing it somewhere. If government is unable to protect it from cyber attacks, it's going to have a grave impact on all of us. Okay. Then we have adversary nations like Pakistan and China. They are constantly attacking us. Pakistan wants to know who are our raw agents. You know, raw, no? Research and analysis wing. So it is responsible for external intelligence gathering. So therefore, there are people, spies, you know, who collect intelligence for our country. So they are posted in many countries. Of course, they will be posted in China, Pakistan, etc. So these people are constantly trying to know who these agents are. There are these adversary nations, they want to know our troop opposition, troop movement, what is our military strength, etc. Okay, so they are constantly trying to attack, gather this information via the internet. For example, you know, an example I can give you, which is called as Stuxnet. Okay, this was some type of virus that the United States sent to hamper the Iran's nuclear program. Okay, so this is an example how things like this can happen. So tomorrow, adversary nations like Pakistan, they can send a virus. This virus will compromise our national security. Okay, things like that. Then radicalization, big problem. You understand this word, right? Radicalization. And especially your ISIS, since your ISIS started, those people, what are they doing? They are using the social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, etc. to hire more people, to, you know, gather supporters, sympathizers. Huh, yes, radicalization. So I will show you some radical content. For example, Shivani, you know, I show you every day some videos that will make you fight for ISIS. Okay, I'm trying to influence you so that you come to Iraq and fight along with me in ISIS ka war. Okay, so that is radicalization, right? So that also it is happening because of the cyber world. India is dependent on technologies and electronic equipment on other countries. Hai ki nahi? We are always buying, no? We want to buy something from Russia right now. Abhi abhi Rafael deal, we tried to close it. We always rely on Israel. We rely on United States to supply us equipment. So, there's a high chance that these are tampered or compromised systems. Let us say you brought Rafael from France. Okay. So, there is a device in the Rafael that you are not aware of. That is constantly, like a GPS, it is tracking where you are. Don't you think that is compromising the security? So, the people, France will always know, ki where is the Rafael going? There's a chance, no? This can happen. There's a chance, right? As a tampered, as a kharab and compromised equipment they are selling you. This is a big problem. Okay. Then our agencies like CERT, NIC, etc., which is supposed to be working towards the cyber security, those agencies are understaffed. They don't have the necessary staff to manage. Okay. Then there is lack of skilled manpower. All our IITians, they are going to United States and working for Facebook, Google. Nobody is left for NIC and CERT, etc. This is another big problem. The skilled manpower is not available. Okay. These are some of the threats that India as a country is facing from cyber issues, cyber attacks. Okay? Chalo, let us talk about different types of cyber threats. What are the different kind of cyber threats? Sir, point one. What is point one? Digital India. Digital India. Usme kya hai? Like for example, Digital India, what are you doing? UPI, you know, no? UPI, Unified Payment Interface. What are you doing? You are transferring money, hai na? So that is a compromise, no? If I am going to do a cyber attack on you, I can make all your money come into my account, no? So that's a threat. That's a threat you are going to face. India as a whole faces because of Digital India. Let us say you put all your documents in the Digi Locker. Okay, let us say you are from a good institution. Okay, so let us say you studied from IIC Bangalore like me, So what do? You put every transcript, you put all your, you know, for example, like all my transcripts and all my degree certificate, etc. They are available on the DigiLocker. Okay. Let us say somebody from the third grade college, he wants something, he wants to apply for big places. So what he does, he accesses my my DigiLocker. He knows how transcripts of me look like. He just, you know, does some Photoshop and puts his name over there. Or he changes my DigiLocker itself. He makes it to his name. So he will become an IAC ka graduate, no? Hai na? So don't you think that is a threat to Digital India? Through Digital India, that is threat to me, no? I'm losing, and somebody who's not genuinely a graduate from a nice place, he's going to get all the benefits. Okay? Then I told you, Aadhaar ka toh I told you. Hai na? Aadhaar ka. How, you know, you have to protect your stuff. I mean, the government has to protect. It's the government's problem. But yeah, it's your problem also, because your data will ultimately get compromised. Theek hai? We'll move forward then. Take it, people. We'll move forward now. Anything else you guys want to ask me? Chalo. Then, types of cyber threats. What are they? Something's called as cyber espionage, cyber crime, cyber terrorism, cyber warfare. Have you heard this term espionage? What does it mean? What do you mean by espionage? Spying. Yes, very good. That's all. Spying. Okay, jasusi. Very good. Yes, cyber espionage. So what is cyber espionage? You use a computer network to gain illicit access to confidential information. For example, let us say RAW is there. It has in its database the names of all the agents, Indian agents, and which place they are posted in. They are in Russia, they are in China, etc. That is there. This is a confidential information. So what does an adversary nation do? Let us say China. Okay. China uses the computer network. It tries to access this confidential information. Okay. It's an illicit access. It's an illegal access. They are not supposed to have access to this information, yet they are accessing it. Okay. Cyber espionage in corporate is called as corporate espionage. See, in corporate sector also, in the business sector also, it happens. For example, let us say there is Jio and there is Airtel. Okay. For some reasons, Airtel feels that Jio is able to provide, services at a cheaper rate. Why? Because the investment is cheaper. Let us say they are spending only 200 rupees and they are selling at 500 rupees. But here Airtel's input cost itself is 300 rupees and they have to sell it at 600 rupees. Okay. So Airtel wants to know how is it that Jio is doing it at just 200 rupees. Okay. So what it does, it tries to steal that data. Spy on Jio using the cyber networks to find the data out. This is corporate espionage. Okay. So this corporate, so cyber espionage, what will happen is when you are stealing such information or when you are stealing information about the troop movement, etc., what are you doing? You are compromising the national security of the country or the economic stability. Okay, you are trying to find out what RBI is doing, etc. That way. Okay, this is cyber espionage. Getting it, people? Not getting it. Chal. Cyber crime or cyber attack. Repeat once. What should I repeat? See, espionage means what? It is stealing data, no? You're spying. You're spying on somebody else. So you are Pakistan and you are spying on India. And for this, you are using the computer network. You are using the internet to do that. You're using internet to get into the system. An offensive manner of targeting the computer information system network, system or a network, devices or any devices with an intention to damage or destroy the target's information capability and system. Let us say I want to commit a cyber attack on you. That means what it basically is, you have a device. Okay, let's say you use your internet. Destroy your information capability. That is basically a cyber attack. Theek hai? I want to destroy your information capability. Matlab, I want to, you to stop using your cell phone. So I destroy your capability of using that cell phone. How? By damaging your data on the cell phone. Damaging the cell phone. You know, it could be a physical damage where I actually, when you're not looking, I actually throw it and, ransomware is another attack. Theek hai? I'll give you. Don't worry. We'll come to ransomware. We'll come to all that. Okay. Not next lesson. In the next few slides, you will see types of cyber attack. So what are the different types of cyber attack? As I told you, first is a physical attack. physically harming the cyber infrastructure. What do I do? For example, let us say you run, you are a NIC, National Informatics Center. Okay. So what do? I put bomb or I cause fire over there. Your information capability goes off, no? Your computers are all there. Your network, etc. Everything is over there. I put bomb over there. It is destroyed. So I am physically harming your computer system. Okay. That is one thing. Then it could be a syntactic attack. What is a syntactic attack? I send in viruses, trojans. I will tell you what these are. Don't worry. Just after 10 more minutes, I will be telling you what exactly these cyber viruses, trojans, etc. Okay? So I send this viruses, etc. This is another way I can attack on you. This is called as a syntactic attack. Okay. And then third, we have which is called as a semantic attack. Here what happens is information is... Okay, so every day, let us say you are sitting in front of the computer, okay, and you are responsible for missile testing of, let us say, BrahMos missile. So every day you are conducting trials and you are saving it in one place. Okay, you are entering 1000, it traveled 1000 kilometers. So what's happening is, when you are entering this data, you are putting in 1000, but when it is getting stored, it is transferred into 500 kilometers. So this is another type of attack. I'm manipulating your data, so that means you don't have the real data available with you. Okay, this is called as a semantic attack. Okay, clear these three? Nations, for example, for terrorism, because these are things that are specifically mentioned in your syllabus. Okay, if you're writing main usually have a political and a social objective also. Let us see how they use cyberspace. How do terrorists use cyberspace? First of all, recruitment of sympathizers towards the causes of ISIS. Okay. So they will target her, maybe depending on what kind of posts she is liking or what kind of videos is she watching. So she will be targeted by ISIS. Okay, and she will be recruited. For example, ISIS is doing just this. It is trying to see who are the vulnerable people. And then they are recruited by ISIS. Okay. And cyberspace is used for this because Twitter, Facebook, etc. are being used for this very purpose. Okay. Then cyberspace is used for propagating lone wolf attacks. Have you seen lone wolf? Have you heard this term? Lone wolf attack? Lone wolf terror attack? No. Are you? Newspaper padho bhai. Kya kar rahe ho? Haan neha. Tell me what is lone wolf attack. Yes, Sai. Tell me what is lone wolf attack. Yes, batao, people who know, let's see, nahi bata do baakiyon ko. One who works alone and terrorizes, sort of, a single man who feels left out in the society, not really, ye to Ned Stark wala, wolf aa gaya, that wolf, the lone wolf dies, but the pack survives, Kasa was not a lone wolf, no. See, lone wolf is basically what happens is, let us say, there is this terror organization ISIS. Okay. There is this person sitting over there. Okay, that's a good idea. Safi is giving me a good idea, good example. Okay. What happens is, this person, he sees a lot of news about ISIS, etc. He is radicalized by this. Okay, they are not targeting him, etc. This person is self-radicalized. He has no support from this parent organization. Although ISIS is not telling him to do something. This person is self-radicalized. He goes as an individual man, takes gun and starts shooting people. Okay, so there is no support from the ISIS directly or indirectly also, for that sake. This person, he was watching all this social media campaigning or what is happening in news, etc. And then he got radicalized and he thinks, chalo, okay, let me kill people. Okay, let me carry out jihad on my own behalf and I will do it. This person goes, takes a gun and shoots 13-14 people. This is lone wolf attack. Okay, why is lone wolf attack taking place? Why? Because social media, because cyberspace, hai na? What I meant is people with that mentality get self-motivated to do so. Yes, that is correct. Theek hai, yeah, that is correct. But it is not because he is a left out in the society or something, you know, radical ideology. They are basically influenced by this. Okay. Chalo, then for planning terrorist attacks, terrorist activities. You use the cyberspace to plan. Then propaganda or radicalization. Okay, ISIS ka apna kahani hai, they try to radicalize you. Furtherance of their social and political objectives. Whatever the social and political objectives of these terror outfits are, they are trying to use the cyberspace to further it. Political objective, just say for example, Nazism wants to spread. What can they do? They can tell you more about what their ideology is, why they are doing it, what kind of change they want to see in the society. That is a way to further their political and social objective. Okay, these are the various ways in which the terrorists are using the cyberspace. Theek hai? Fine, not fine? Chalo, very good. Let us talk about cyber warfare. You know war, no? You know war, right? Of course. Land, sea, air, space. These are the four traditional places where war is carried out. Land mein you have army, sea mein you have navy, air mein you have air force. Then now even space we are doing. Jaise abhi toh everybody is relying on satellites. So for example, if I want to attack on India, I will take out India's communication satellites. Hai na? So we are, China is developing this, anti-satellite missiles. Have you heard about this? Anti-satellite missiles? No. Yes. Naam se pata chal raha hai kya hoga na, but these are missiles that will take down a satellite. It will destroy a satellite. So therefore now you have extended your war to the space also. If two countries are fighting, they will try to take each other's satellites out so that they are handicapped, so that they don't have this, communication, etc. is down, global positioning system does not work, etc. And now we have a fifth domain, which is the cyberspace. Cyberspace is the fifth domain of space army. Yes, for example, yes, space army. You have the Outer Space Treaty, you can read about it. Called as an Outer Space Treaty. Okay. Anyway, chalo. So as you can see, cyberspace, the cyber world has become the fifth domain of warfare. If you want to carry out a warfare against a country, you can use the cyberspace also. Two countries fighting in the cyber world. Okay. Action by a nation state or its proxy. To destroy or damage or compromise the cyber architecture of the target country with an intention of espionage, vandalism or sabotage. You want to destroy the other country's cyber capabilities. Cyber down, so everything is down, no? You have blocked out RAW, you have blacked out army ka. Theek hai? This is cyber warfare. Two countries fighting in the cyber domain, that is all. A war that is raging on in the cyber domain. Theek hai? Fine? Chalo. These are the different things. Now let us try to understand the different types of cyber attack, because I am trying to stress on different types of cyber attack. Why? Because of ransomware. Okay, maybe all cannot be completed today. I'll try to complete as much as possible. Okay, this is ransomware tha, or what else? What else can you say? Stuxnet. Okay, all these things. Petya. Matlab, ransomware WannaCry tha. Okay, WannaCry is the name of the ransomware. Chalo. We will deal with such cyber attacks. What are the different types of cyber attacks that can be carried out? First, the very basic is a virus. And ye to suna hi hoga na? Virus, very very common. Okay. What it does is it attaches itself with a program or an application. Just say you downloaded the Unacademy app. So Unacademy app mein there is a virus. Or you are running some program, just say tum Counter Strike khel rahe ho, you downloaded that. Along with Counter Strike, when it is opening, your virus is also running. It is basically, it attaches it with a program or an application and it starts to run along when the program is executed. Let us say you have downloaded an Academy app and usme you have a virus. So when you are running an Academy app, your virus is also constantly doing something. It is also activated. What it does is it will either corrupt or destroy your data. For example, it is deleting all your video files, or it is deleting all your personal files, you know, video file, image file, document, etc. And or it can also render your system useless, as it constantly it keeps on deleting, corrupting your data. And finally, basically, yes, it is interrupting you at the short stage, and in the long run, it is going to render your system useless. Just say you're watching it from a laptop, your laptop is kharab kar dega. ठीक है, बिकॉज इट इज करप्टिंग इंपॉर्टेंट फाइल्स. जैसे ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम के इफ यू इफ ऑल द फाइल्स गो, इट इज गॉन. ठीक है, दिस इज द इंटेंशन ऑफ अ वायरस. नो, हाउ, व्हाई डू यू वांट टू यूज वायरस फॉर हेल्पिंग ग्रोथ ऑफ समवन? हाउ डू, आई मीन, थिंक ऑफ दैट. नो, मतलब वायरस मीन्स व्हाट? इट इज एनीथिंग, इट कैन डू एनीथिंग. फॉर एग्जांपल, व्हाट यू वांट टू क्रिएट अ वायरस दैट विल डू समबडीज होमवर्क, चलो बना दो, दैट विल हेल्प समवन. ठीक है, you have a kid, that person likes to watch Kaun Banega Crorepati, theek hai, so you know he is watching this, so when he is running that application, or let us say an academy, when an academy app is being run, you can send a virus that will do your homework for the kid also. Theek hai, kar lo. Kar sakte ho, that will help people. Thoda unrealistic hai, but okay, it is called a cyber attack for a reason. Nobody attacks you for helping you. ठीक है, चलो, नेक्स्ट इज ट्रोजन. ओके, व्हाट इज अ ट्रोजन? हैव यू हर्ड द स्टोरी अबाउट द ट्रोजन हॉर्सेस दैट वर यूज्ड एज अ ट्रिक बाय ग्रीक्स टू कॉन्कर द इंडिपेंडेंट सिटी ऑफ ट्रॉय? हैव यू हर्ड द स्टोरी, द वुडन हॉर्स? चलो, वेरी गुड, एवरीबॉडी हैज हर्ड. चलो, ग्रेट यार. हाँ, बेसिकली ट्रोजन इज ऑल्सो लाइक दिस, इट्स अ डिकॉय. ठीक है, प्रोग्राम्स व्हेन रन दे प्रिटेंडेड टू डू वन थिंग, बट इन एक्चुअल देयर पर्पसेस एंड देयर फंक्शंस आर कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट. Okay, let us say you are learning an academy app. You have run an academy app. Okay, so it pretends, just say it is showing that you are watching videos and tum seekh rahe ho. It is pretending to do that, but what is it actually doing that you are not aware of? Maybe it is deleting all your data. Maybe it is revealing all your data to somebody. Theek hai? That way, this is called as a trojan. Okay, the idea they steal, corrupt, compromise or manipulate data. Even it is manipulating data. Jaise tumne likha, aaj maine 1000 rupees kamaye. I earned 1000 rupees today. Okay, then it will change this 1000 to 500. This is manipulation of data. Okay, on the face of it, it's a decoy. It according to you, it's an app for watching videos. That is according to you, that is what it is doing. But in reality, it is deleting your files. Okay, this is basically a trojan. The same trick, the way the city of Troy, the independent city of Troy, got tricked, you are also tricked into this. Okay, then you heard this term, no, malware. ठीक है, मॉल मीन्स बैड, जैसे व्हेन यू से मॉल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सेट्रा. ठीक है, नो, जैसे इफ यू सी इंसेप्शन, द वाइफ ऑफ कॉब, हर नेम इज मॉल, नो, बैड, रिमेंबर लाइक दिस, दैट मीन्स बैड. ठीक है, इट्स अ मेलिशियस सॉफ्टवेयर, इट्स अ बैड सॉफ्टवेयर, इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज डेटा. आर यू बिलोंग टू साउथ इंडिया? I was born in Tamil Nadu, but I've been brought up in Delhi. Theek hai. Then I went for college back to South India for 5 years, and then I came back to Delhi. Theek hai. Chalo. I don't think from my accent you will ever get to know whether I'm a South Indian or not. This is a malicious software, okay? This is a malware. I don't know, I get asked this question quite a lot. A lot of people ask me. Your pronunciation tells it. Really? My pronunciation? What did I pronounce? I don't know, yaar. Chalo, theek hai. Kya farak padta hai? It is because of your accent. By your name. Okay. Chalo, very good. Chalo, mera analysis karna band karo. Cyber analysis karte hain. Okay. Let's go. Hacking. Very familiar, no? You're familiar with this? Hacking? Yes. What is hacking? It is basically, you find and exploit the weaknesses in a computer system. Okay, famous one. Very good. So basically, what is it? Let us say, you steal data, you delete data, whatever. Okay, that is up to you. So basically, let us say there is a locked house. Okay, so what do you try to do if you want to rob the house? What will you do? You will try to look for weaknesses, no? Jaise ye khidki khula hai kya? Can I break this house from here? Noise will be less, or this is a very weak spot, I can just cut a hole over here and enter, etc. This is what hacking is. They try to see the weaknesses in your system, and using that weaknesses, they exploit that weakness to get in. जैसे दे से फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर इज अ लॉक्ड हाउस, देर इज नो वे टू गेट इन, बट देन देर आर सीइंग एट द फर्स्ट फ्लोर देर इज अ ग्लास विंडो एंड दे हैव इक्विपमेंट्स टू कट द ग्लास एंड एंटर, दैट इज अ वीकनेस. Okay. Similarly, the hackers, what they do is they try to find these weaknesses and they will enter into your system. And once they enter into the system, they can commit fraud, they can commit privacy invasion, they will take away your personal data, stealing corporate or personal data, etc. These are various things that you can do after hacking. Okay? And this is another term, it's just called as ethical hacking. ठीक है, एथिकल हैकिंग व्हाट डू यू डू इट फॉर ऑल द राइट रीजंस. तो यू थिंक लाइक अ हैकर, ओके, यू लुक फॉर वीकनेसेस. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाट विल एन एथिकल हैकर डू, ही विल रोम अराउंड द हाउस, ही विल थिंक लाइक हाउ अ रॉबर विल थिंक एंड ही विल सी अच्छा ये तो दिस इज अ ग्लास विंडो, मे बी पीपल विल ब्रेक फ्रॉम हियर, ही विल पॉइंट इट आउट एंड ही विल टेल यू व्हाट टू डू टू यू नो मेक थिंग्स बेटर सो दैट यू नो हैकिंग डज नॉट टेक प्लेस. सो ही ट्राइज टू प्रोटेक्ट यू, यस. By thinking like a robber, by thinking like a hacker, he will try to see what are the weaknesses and they will try to overcome those weaknesses. Okay? This is ethical hacking. Then, you heard this term phishing? Where have you heard this term phishing? Aega yaar, Gmail wagera use karte ho, if you use Gmail and all, it will show. This seems like a phishing site. You heard, no? This seems like a phishing site. It just comes written, okay, fine, that is correct. It says, no, most of the time it will warn you, don't submit your personal data. It seems like a phishing site. What is this? A person pretends to be someone else to make the victim reveal personal information over the net. Okay, this is it. For example, let us say, you get a message one day. They will say, I am an SBI bank manager. Okay, I'm an SBI bank manager from so-and-so. We need, if there is a good investment plan, please invest money. Okay, they will send you all sort of credentials, all sort of things to make you believe. Okay, in reality, it's not an SBI bank manager. It is a fraudster, it's a trickster. Okay, they will try to make you believe that this person is an SBI, huh, exactly. Okay, SBI bank manager, and you will one day believe and you will submit your details also. This details once submitted, this person will use all that information, all that important data to steal, cheat you. ठीक है, this is called as a phishing. ठीक है, समझ रहे हो? It is just a way. I pretend to be someone I am not, and I make you reveal all your personal details, and then I will steal from you or do whatever. Okay, the idea is to take to steal your personal information. Okay, and nowadays there is this one more thing these people are doing. They say, for example, you know, like let's say you are going to get your passbook photocopied or your checkbook, etc., something photocopied. So what they are doing is asking for card number, etc. Basically, so what they are doing is when they keep it on the photocopy machine, okay, they are printing one and giving one copy to you. Second copy, they are doing it when you are not looking and they are keeping to themselves. Okay, so there you have your address written, you have some account number, etc., written. Then these people will call you. Okay, they will just pass it on to some fraud people. These people will call you. Okay, they will act like a bank. They will tell you that, see, this is your name, this is where you live, this is your account number, etc. Okay, so you will also believe, you will think, achha, ye toh sahi mein bank hona chahiye, because they know. Arey baba, I am not scaring, I am telling you the reality, yaar. Ignorance is bliss, sir. But you cannot be ignorant. Hai na? Batao, ignorant rehna hai kya? Now that you know these things are happening. मतलब दिस इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ टुडेज डिस्कशन ऑन साइबर सिक्योरिटी, बट आई एम टेलिंग यू, है ना, दिस इज वॉट हैपन्स इन रियलिटी, दिस इज वन वे इट्स हैपनिंग. ठीक है, सो यू विल गेट अ कॉल, दिस पर्सन विल गिव यू ऑल डिटेल्स, दिस पर्सन विल मेक यू बिलीव दैट यू ही इज द बैंक, बिकॉज यू नो ही इज सेइंग योर अकाउंट नंबर उसको पता है, तुम कहाँ पे रहते हो वो भी पता है, तो यू सी एस दिस इज द ओनली इन्फॉर्मेशन आई गेव टू द बैंक, तो यू स्टार्ट टू बिलीव दम, दे विल से आई थिंक देर इज यू नीड टू ब्लॉक योर कार्ड, सो गिव मी द डिटेल्स ऑफ द कार्ड, यू विल बिलीव इट्स द बैंक एंड यू विल गिव अवे एंड दीज पीपल टेक द मनी. अरे मतलब सारे जेरोक्स गाइज नहीं, ठीक है, सम आर देयर, सम प्लेसेस दे आर डूइंग इट, दे सेल दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन. मैं ये नहीं कि मारने लग गए आज वापस जाके, ये सब मत करना. सम पीपल डू इट, ओके, नॉट एवरी वन इज बैड. इरुंब सट्टाई, अच्छा, नो, आई एम नॉट अवेयर ऑफ, आई मीन आई डेंट सी दैट मूवी, आई सी वेरी लेस मूवीज. चलो, देन स्पूफिंग. This is means ullu banana. You trick someone, you fool someone. A spoofing attack is a situation. Each bank branch supports customers to be aware and not to reveal about their account details. Yes, it is true. Every day you also get, no, RBI also sends messages that please don't reveal sensitive information, don't share your card numbers with anybody, etc. Don't do that. It just requires half a minute and they will be out with the money. So be very careful in such matters. Don't reveal crucial personal information to others. You never know what they are using. And suppose some log they baithe hain aadhar ke liye, you never know kab kya chori ho raha hai. Chalo, anyway, yeah, I mean, like, provided, I mean, if you have to believe the government, they are saying we have foolproof methods to protect the data, and I hope that is true. I hope that is true. They are able to protect the data, which is very good. Hum log bina aadhar ho jayenge. Abhi kya aadhar ho jaoge? Submit kar chuke ho, theek hai? Gaya wo नेटवर्क में है, क्लाउड में है, जहां भी है, हर जगह है. कल देखो नया सफी आएगा. टुमारो न्यू सफी विल कम. ही विल लिसन टू दिस लेक्चर ओनली, बट ही वोंट बी यू. ही विल हैव योर आधार नंबर, ही विल हैव योर पैन नंबर, ही विल पे योर टैक्सेस आल्सो, बट ही वोंट बी यू. ठीक है. हाँ, गवर्नमेंट मे नॉट हैव दैट, वी कैन नॉट से, नो, मतलब आई नो वेरी लिटिल अबाउट देयर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एक्सेट्रा. ठीक है. So we have to believe, they are saying, chalo, theek hai, de diya, ab kya karein? We can only hope for the best and plan for the worst. I don't know what is plan for worst, so we can only hope for best. Theek hai? Chalo, anyway, now, the worst part is that, you know, there are a lot of people who think, that yaar, mera leke kya kar lenge? Anghuta hi to hai. Matlab, they seriously think, this is just a biometric, what can I do with that? Arre, bahut kuch kar sakte hai, yaar. Nothing is foolproof. Yes, that is true. Nothing is foolproof. That is also true. For example, recently that person gave, no, his Aadhaar details. He said, do what you want with that. And people showed what they can do with that. So don't take it very lightly ki theek hai, fingerprint hai, signature hai, let us just give it. What will they do? I have no money. I have nothing. Kal pata chala tumhare upar murder ka case aa gaya. Ho sakta hai na? Haan. ठीक है. सो बी वेरी केयरफुल. डोंट थिंक कि क्या कर लेंगे. आई एम सच अ इनोसेंट पर्सन, व्हाट विल दे डू. आई हैव हार्डली 10,000 रुपी इन माय अकाउंट. चोरी करके क्या कर लेंगे. तो फाइन, आई विल शेयर. नहीं यार, यू डोंट हैव दिस एटीट्यूड. एंड व्हेन यू सी समबडी हैज दिस एटीट्यूड, यू हैव टू स्टॉप देम. बहुत कुछ हो सकता है. ओके, यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर अ प्रेस्टिजियस एग्जामिनेशन. ठीक है, बहुत कुछ हो सकता है. दे कैन मिसयूज योर इन्फॉर्मेशन इन मेनी मैटर्स. ठीक है. कांट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट, व्हाट कैन यू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड रिव्यू. अरे स्पूफिंग पहुंचा ही नहीं, मैं समझाना है. आई डिडंट इवन स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेनिंग स्पूफिंग टू यू येट. अरे बाबा, आई डिडंट इवन स्टार्ट यार. हाँ, अ स्पूफिंग अटैक इज अ सिचुएशन इन विच वन पर्सन और प्रोग्राम सक्सेसफुली मैस्करेड्स एज अनदर. मैस्करेड्स, शशि थरूर को फॉलो नहीं कर रहे हो क्या? क्या यार, लोग जीआरई क्लियर कर रहे हैं. चल, एनीवे, डोंट फॉरगेट दैट, लीव दैट. ठीक है. अ स्पूफिंग अटैक बाय फॉल्सिफाइंग डेटा देयर बाय गेनिंग इलेजिटिमेट एक्सेस. लेट अस से, यू नो, देयर इज दिस लैब. ओके, इनसाइड, टू गेन एक्सेस टू दिस लैब देयर इज अ बायोमेट्रिक सेंसर एंड आई ओनली हैव एक्सेस. सो दैट मींस एज लॉन्ग एज आई पुट माय थंब इंप्रेशन आई कैन गेट एक्सेस टू इट. इफ एनीबडी एल्स ट्राइज टू पुट देयर थंब इंप्रेशन दे आर नॉट अलाउड. Okay, so what happens is, what exactly is spoofing is basically you fool this biometric sensor. Okay, that is testing your fingerprint. You are nobody, you are not me. Okay, suppose it is Revu. Revu does not have access to that particular lab. So what Revu does is, Revu puts his finger or her finger. I don't know, Revu ladki hai na, pehli baar sun raha hu, unique naam hai. Chalo, theek hai, his or her finger over there. Okay, and then they get access. So Revu is not supposed to be having access to that place, but still Revu is able to access the place. This is spoofing. Matlab, you are fooling the biometric sensor. Theek hai? Some way or the other, you have tampered with the system so that you are getting access. This is spoofing. Samajh gaye kya? You want me to repeat? Anybody? Fine? Not fine. Kisi ko problem hai to batao yaar. We will accept. We'll explain it. It's very unique. Rarest of rare name. Achha. I mean, like, ठीक है. वो, is it girl or is it boy? I mean, male or female? That also I want to know. It's a very unique name. I'm also curious about what it means also. मेल, अच्छा व्हाट डज इट मीन, पहली बार सुन रहा हूँ मैं रिव्यू. चलो नेक्स्ट इज डिनायल ऑफ सर्विस अटैक. हैव यू हर्ड दिस टर्म डिनायल ऑफ सर्विस? ये भी तो हुआ था यार रिसेंटली, डिनायल ऑफ सर्विस अटैक. ओके यस, एनीबडी कैन टेल मी व्हाट दैट इज? अच्छा रिव्यू मीन्स द सेवियर ऑफ द सोसाइटी. चलो माई बेस्ट विशेज फॉर यू टू बिकम अ सिविल सर्वेंट एंड बी द सेवियर ऑफ द सोसाइटी फ्रॉम ऑल दीज क्राउजेस वी हैव, फ्रॉम करप्शन टू मॉल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. आई होप यू आर द सेवियर एंड यू आर ट्रू टू योर नेम ऑल्सो. चलो टेल मी व्हाट इज द डिनायल ऑफ सर्विस अटैक. यस इट वॉज इन द न्यूज, ऐसे गेस करो कुछ बताओ. और यू कैन गिव मी वाई एन एग्जाम्पल ऑल्सो, यू कैन टेल मी व्हाट इट मीन्स. नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विस विच इज सपोज टू. ओके टू सम एक्सटेंट फाइन, ठीक है. लेट अस से ठीक है, ओके अटैक टू ओवरवेलम द टारगेट वेबसाइट्स. ओके टारगेटेड वेबसाइट्स, लेट अस से आई टारगेट द यूपीएससी का वेबसाइट, ठीक है. लेट अस से टुमारो इज द डे, टुमारो क्या है, सेप्टेम्बर 9. ओके नहीं सेप्टेम्बर तो खत्म हो गया, अक्टूबर 9 है टुमारो. अक्टूबर 9 इज द डे. ओके योर यूपीएससी रिजल्ट्स आर आउट. ओके एवरीबडी विल बी चेकिंग देयर यूपीएससी वेबसाइट नो, हर कोई एक्सेस कर रहा है, हर कोई एक्सेस कर रहा है टू ट्राइंग टू एक्सेस यूपीएससी का वेबसाइट. व्हाट डू आई डू is I overwhelm this website, I keep attacking this website so that UPSC cannot provide you the service it is supposed to provide. What service is that? To announce the results. It is not able to announce the result because I have overwhelmed the website. Okay, I keep on attacking the website. I try to deny UPSC from providing its service. Achha, hua bhi tha when mains admit card were uploaded. I am not aware yaar. I didn't even appear for this year prelims. I appeared for last year mains only. Chalo. What was I saying? Theek hai, you're getting the idea. So you attack a site so that they are not able to provide. And you are denying legitimate users access to a computer or a computer network or a website. Matlab, you are a legitimate user. Tum sahi mein janna chahte ho if I'm selected or not. You are a legitimate user. You, a legitimate user, are not able to access the service that the website is providing to you. Okay, this is the denial of service attack. Getting this? Fine. How was your mains experience? Mains experience bada hectic tha. I mean it's too tiring. You'll get tired, that's all. I mean at least this year also I have seen that they have given some 1 week ka gap, no? So last time when I appeared it wasn't there. Lagatar ek ke baad ek, ek ke baad ek, ek ke baad aage hota hai. It's just a tiring experience, that's all. Matlab, 6 hours a day. That is one thing. Because maybe, you know, I was not used to this kind of system. Matlab, earlier, to, before this, I was doing masters, so mostly it was research only and not many exams were there. So I was not used to writing so much. And mine was mathematically intensive course, so math karna tha. Lik-lik ki aadat nahi thi, so maybe I felt a little tired. But yeah, with a lot of practice, you should be fine. ठीक है चलो मूव फॉरवर्ड. ओके देन वी हैव डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड डिनायल ऑफ सर्विस अटैक. ओके व्हाट इज दिस डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड डिनायल ऑफ सर्विस अटैक? सिंपल, तो हियर इंस्टेड ऑफ फ्रॉम अ सिंगल सोर्स इट्स कोऑर्डिनेटेड फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सोर्सेज. लेट अस से यूपीएससी वेबसाइट इज अ टारगेट. ओके वन पर्सन इज अटैकिंग फ्रॉम यूएसए, one person is attacking from New Zealand, one person from Canada, one person from UK, one person from India itself, and one person from, let us say, Australia. Okay. So many people are attacking. Okay. The source of attack is not a single source. It is coordinated. We are all coordinating. Chalo, aaj 10 baje. We will do together. Okay. 10 o'clock, Greenwich mein, GMT, we will all attack UPSC ka website. This is called as a distributed denial of service attack. The source is not single, multiple sources that are coordinating an attack. Okay, this is the difference between a denial of service attack and a distributed denial of service attack. A distributed denial of service attack is a sub part of the denial of service attack. If this is denial of service attack, this is distributed denial of service attack. Okay, fine. Move forward. See, these are the things you should know. Why? Because of course, first, they are in the news. And second thing is UPSC has the tendency to ask from topics around the topic that are in the news. Just say, for example, ransomware was in the news. तो यूपीएससी माइट नॉट आस्क डायरेक्टली रैनसमवेयर. तो व्हाट यूपीएससी माइट आस्क इज यू कैन टॉक अबाउट द अदर थ्रेट्स, अदर साइबर अटैक्स दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग. तो दे विल आस्क यू व्हाट इज स्पूफिंग एक्सेट्रा. ठीक है, सो दैट इज द रीजन आई एम डूइंग इट, बिकॉज इफ यू सी स्पेशली इन साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी gravitational waves and things like that were too much in the news. UPSC did not directly ask anything, but it asked from around the topic. Okay, so it is very crucial for you to understand not just topics that are in the news, but around the topic also. Okay, that are connected directly to those topics. Okay, that is how you prepare for science and technology at least. Okay, preparing for science and technology is very, very easy. Okay, the most easiest throwaway jo karte hain wo log 10-15 marks ke, that is science and technology. Yeah, try to get that. चलो, that will really make a difference. ठीक है, and I think one of the main reasons why I could clear it in the first go, the prelims examination, is because of my knowledge about science and technology and environment. भरा रहता है पूरा paper, physical geography, your science and technology and environment, easily you can clear. ये बाकी quality तो हर कोई कर लेता है. Don't think कि लक्ष्मीकांत सिर्फ तुम्हें समझ आ रहा है. Every 9 lakh people appearing, everybody understands लक्ष्मीकांत. ठीक है, everybody is getting those right. What is going to take you across the cutoff marks is how you score in all these things, the science and technology or your environment, etc. Okay, har koi Lakshmikant karke aata hai, har kisi ko history aati hai. Theek hai, so if you think reading that you will get across the exam, no, you're very, very mistaken. Okay, see, it's okay, it does not matter yaar which background you belong to. Okay, these are some basic stuff. You start with the NCERTs, you build up on the knowledge. They are not asking you very, very, you know, very specific or something very tough. So, jo news mein hai, they want you to understand what is happening. That is all. Okay, it does not matter ki tum commerce background se ho ya humanities background. It does not matter, seriously. Okay? Jaise for example, Vivu, tell me, we have been discussing these topics. Okay? Did it affect you that you are from a commerce background anywhere in this topic? Tell me. I have discussed around 22 slides as of now. Tell me, in the 22 slides, did you ever feel that, you know, because of commerce background, I'm not understanding what you're saying? Did you feel like that? No, of course not. So therefore, all the science and topics are also like this only. They don't want you to know bachelor's level or master's level physics, chemistry, math. No, they're not expecting that. These are things that are in the news, which the understanding is also very easy. So these are the things they are asking, and it is easy for you to answer these. So don't think that you being from a specific background is hampering your choices in any manner whatsoever. Okay, so ye nikal do. Yes, I mean, I don't know about commerce optional, yaar. that depends on your interest and your capability. Okay, I'm not the best person to suggest an optional subject for anyone else. Okay, trendy, no idea. पूछ लेना जिसने कॉमर्स से लिखा हो, उसको पता होगा. चलो, लेट अस टॉक दिस. यू हैव सीन हर्ड कीबोर्ड लॉगिंग और की लॉगर. हैव यू हर्ड दिस टर्म? यस. व्हाट डज इट डू, टेल मी. हर्ड, ओनली हर्ड. हाँ, बताओ कोई बताओ यार. किसी ने यूज नहीं किया कीबोर्ड लॉगर? की लॉगर कैप्चर्स व्हाट एवर यू टाइप. यस, थैंक यू सो मच साई, वेरी गुड. ठीक है, तो बेसिकली व्हेन अ की लॉगर इज इंस्टॉल्ड इन योर कंप्यूटर, व्हेन एवर यू टाइप समथिंग, लेट अस से आई एम राइट नाउ प्रेसिंग के, दैट के विल गेट रजिस्टर्ड, देन एल, दैट एल विल बी रजिस्टर्ड, एस विल बी रजिस्टर्ड, आई विल बी रजिस्टर्ड. सपोज दिस इज माय पासवर्ड. ओके, लेट अस से दिस इज माय फेसबुक. फेसबुक आई एंटर्ड यूजर नेम, देन आई एम एंटरिंग पासवर्ड. ओके, लेट अस से द की लॉगर इज एक्टिव राइट नाउ. सो वट एवर आई एम टाइपिंग, प्रेसिंग ऑन माय कीबोर्ड, पासवर्ड ऐसे टाइप करते हो ना, यू प्रेस ऑन द कीबोर्ड, तो यू पुट दिस पासवर्ड ओवर हियर. ठीक है, व्हाट हैपेंड, it has captured the keylogger caps whatever buttons I'm typing, it is getting captured. Okay, so somebody else will know my password. This is what a keylogger does. Basically, it logs every single key that you are pressing on the keyboard. Okay, not really, virtual keyboard won't be tracked by a keylogger. Okay, virtual keyboard is not supposed to be tracked by a keylogger. Matlab the traditional one does not do it. बट अभी पता नहीं, पीपल, एज आई टोल्ड यू, थिंग्स आर कॉन्स्टेंटली इवॉल्विंग. मे बी अभी किसी ने की लॉगर निकाल लिया, विच कैन इवन डू द वर्चुअल वन ऑल्सो. आई मीन दैट आई डोंट नो, इट इज़ पॉसिबल दैट कुछ आ गया होगा, पीपल वुड हैव डेवलप्ड अ सॉफ्टवेयर, यू नेवर नो. बट एज फार एज आई नो, मतलब एज फार एज पहले जो वर्चुअल कीबोर्ड यूज़ करते थे, वाई, बिकॉज द की लॉगर वॉज एबल टू ओनली कैप्चर द की स्ट्रोक्स. सो इफ यू यूज अ वर्चुअल, देन इट डज नॉट हैपन. बट एज आई एम टेलिंग यू, किसी ने सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलप कर लिया होगा. Somebody could have developed this software which is capturing this virtual keystrokes also. Possible. Why not? What is impossible about it? people are making virus trojan and all, making that is not very difficult. Take care. Fine. Chalo. Then this is very crucial. We'll discuss about ransomware and then stop. Okay. I will do a part 2 if you guys are interested of this particular series. Okay. There are some, I mean, not so very important, but still, hai thode aur, we can discuss if you guys want. Okay. Chalo. Then I'll discuss ransomware because this was in the news. So we will discuss this. Ransomware is a type of malicious software that threatens to publish the victim's data or perpetually block access to it unless a ransom is paid. What is a ransom? Jaise tumhara bachcha kidnap ho gaya, your son or daughter got kidnapped. Okay, you receive a call. They will say, give me money, give me $20 billion, I will release your son or daughter. Okay, that is what are they doing? They are asking you for a ransom. So here what happens is, who gets kidnapped is your data gets kidnapped. Let us say, okay, you are a scientist working for DRDO. Okay. So your computer got hit by this ransomware. So all your data gets encrypted. Encrypted, you understand the meaning? That means it is password protected. Okay. Let's say you have data about the missile. Okay. So you are trying to log in. It says if you want to access this file after the ransomware attack, it will say if you want to access this file, if you want to access this file, type the password. Okay. Type the password. But you don't have the password, no? The person who carried out the ransomware attack, he's the one who had password. Hai ki nahi? Okay. So therefore, you don't have this password. So they will say, if you want the password, please pay me this money. Okay. You have no other option if you want to access this data. You have to pay the money. Once the money is paid, they will release this password. Okay, they will release this password, and when you type the password, whatever data got encrypted, they get decrypted. Okay, this is what basically a ransomware does. And see, they asked this one, the ransom in the form of bitcoins. Okay, have you guys attended my course on bitcoins and crypto, bitcoins and blockchain technology? Yes, Mitra, I remember you were there. Alok, yes, Archie, acha, haan, chalo, tum log to ho. Haan, so we already discussed now what is the advantage of using bitcoins. It is anonymous. Tumhe pata nahi chal raha to whom you are giving the money. So it is very safe to make such a transfer. So they were asking bitcoins mein do. People also had to pay them. They paid in the form of bitcoins. Then finally they sent the password. Those people sent the password, those attackers, and they could retrieve their data. Some, despite using the password, also could not retrieve their data. Okay. So this was the ransomware attack, and the ransomware's name was WannaCry. Okay. Used it as currency. Okay, it's called a cryptocurrency. Fine, people, wanna cry? Okay, this is basically what a ransomware does. Okay, and at the end of the session, there's a thumbs up or a thumbs down. So depending on whether you liked the class, you can give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down. That's totally up to you if you feel benefited, etc. Now, how can we protect yourselves from cyber attack? Countries like America, Russia, Japan have 24-hour in India. So what is the solution for it? Solution for that, okay. Solution for that, kya ho sakta hai? See, there are many things you can do is by, for example, just say having an antivirus is to start with. Matlab, tumhe, if you want to save your system, you have a good antivirus, or you can use the Apple products. I mean, they are relatively immune to these viruses and all. Theek hai. Those are some ways you can do it. Okay. It is true. I mean, we cannot do anything. Hona to hoga. Just a ransomware hua tha. If it has to happen, it will happen. Okay. So whatever little we can do, we will try to do that. Just say on your side also, there is this NIC, certain, etc. Even they are working on cyber security. So on behalf of you, they are putting up a lot of effort to protect you from cyber security. Matlab, cyber security threats. Okay. It's a constant fight. Okay. From your side, what minimal you can do is you cannot don't download this, apps that are not trusted. Those are not trusted apps. Then those apps that want to take information from you, etc. Or you should not, keeping your antivirus updated. That's one small thing you can do. Okay. Chalo then. And if you're interested, there's also a comprehensive science and tech course also. You can try to... I'm sorry. Last time when the class was cancelled, I was the only guy who was cracking jokes. Today I'm telling you this because yesterday I made it one. अच्छा नो नो इट्स ओके यार, देखो ये छोटे मोटे काम मैं नहीं करता, ठीक है, डोंट वरी, यू यू कैन अब्यूज मी ऑल्सो, आई डोंट केयर. सी मैं सीधा बता रहा हूँ, आई डोंट केयर, यू नो दैट्स माई एटीट्यूड, डोंट वरी, डोंट बॉदर अबाउट इट, आई एम नॉट अफेंडेड, ठीक है, मैं इस चीज़ें पढ़ता भी नहीं हूँ. आई मीन आई डोंट थिंक यू शुड ऑल्सो बी इन्फ्लुएंस बिकॉज वॉट अदर्स से शुड नॉट इन्फ्लुएंस यू, वो जो कहें, ठीक है, डोंट वरी, डोंट बॉदर अबाउट इट, डोंट अपोलोजाइज एंड ऑल. कंटेन्स सॉफ्टवेयर, सी गूगल, गूगल में जब वेन यू ट्राई टू डाउनलोड इट सेल्फ, नो दैट इज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम दे से दैट दिस इज नॉट अ ट्रस्टेड सॉफ्टवेयर, यू गेट दिस मैसेज. एंड मोस्टली गूगल प्ले में आई थिंक इट इज यूजली जो ट्रस्टेड है वही है, ठीक है, इफ यू ट्राई टू डाउनलोड ऐप फ्रॉम एल्सवेयर मे बी इट इज नॉट प्रोटेक्टेड, ठीक है. ओह ऑसम क्लास, थैंक यू सो मच यार, इट्स यूर एनकरेजिंग कमेंट्स दैट मेक मी वॉन्ट टू कम बैक. ऑथेंटिक साइट्स एंड ऐप्स, यस दैट इज ट्रू, ठीक है, चलो देन we'll call it a day guys, nice meeting all of you, okay, so all of you have a good day, bye bye and see you soon.